Myself Ms. Tejasri Kosbe, lecturer from Pravin Patil Polytechnic Bhayandar. My subject is maintenance of electrical equipment, and this chapter 2 is maintenance schedule, part 4. Learning outcomes. At the end of this video, you will learn about routine preventive maintenance of transformers and preventive maintenance of induction motor. So, routine preventive maintenance of transformers. So this includes overall visual inspection without dismantling, checking oil level through glass window in conservator tank and cooling systems. Third, leakage bushings and conservators. Fourth, breather silica gel color. Falling tests are performed in the routine maintenance of transformer. These are: first one is measurement of insulation resistance, second is transformer oil breakdown voltage test, and third, gas sample analysis from Bogos relay. Third is mechanical maintenance. In this you have to check tightens, off fittings, nut bolts, oil deposits, dust deposits are scrapped and removed from bushing or tanks or tubes, etc. Third, silica gel removal if color is observed to be changed from pink to blue. Fourth, to make up oil level in the tank by adding oil. Fifth one is contaminated oil to be drained out for filtering. So these steps are followed in mechanical maintenance. Next one is periodic maintenance. So in this includes the following test. First one is dielectric test, second acidity test, third is crackle test, and fourth one is moisture containment. Next topic is preventive maintenance of induction motor. In general, the machine should be stopped and isolated from all supplies before any maintenance work is done. The frequency of maintenance required depends to a large extent upon the site's conditions. Second, clean the winding of motors against affected due to surrounding atmosphere condition. Third one is air passage for ventilation blown out regularly to avoid interference with cooling system. Fourth, renew switchgear and fuse worn out contacts, that is starter. Fifth, for brushes, replace worn out brushes for brushes of similar grade. Adjust the brush pressure properly. Free movement of brushes in the respective box must be ensuring. Check that the brushes are sitting properly on the slip ring and tension is uniform. Care should be taken that brushes should be vibrating in holders when motor is running. Replace if brushes are worn out within 3 mm of their support arm. Brushes should be checked after every 100 hours running. Sixth is slip rings. Replace slip rings if it is uneven wear. Clean the slip ring dust. Tight the connections from winding to slip rings. Seventh, for bearing, replace worn out bearing by equipment bearings of similar type. Clean and recharge the bearings after every 3000 hours of running. Use sandpaper to clean the contacts between brushes and slip ring by manually rotating armature, and finally clean with dry cloth in the direction of rotation only. Do not use different grade of grease. Add lubricating oil if necessary in case of lubricating motors. In case of indirect drive, check the belt tension, and if found excess, it should be reduced. Make alignment properly. Next is air gap should be periodically checked with a filler gauge to ensure against a worn bearing that might permit the rotor to rub against the stator core. Even slight rubbing of the rotor against the stator will generate enough heat to destroy the coil insulation. This check is needed particularly for sleeve bearing motors. 9th, do properly maintenance of cooling system. Check the insulation resistance and polarization index. If it is not satisfactory, then machine should clean and drying test is conducted to improve the insulation resistance. 11th, check continuity of earth conductor. If found open, correct it. 12th is tight all the connections in terminal box and starting unit. 13 is check the condition of foundation and found any defect, rectify it. 14, checking of base plate fixing on foundation. Next topic is effect of absence of maintenance. Falling things, if it not taken care of, then life of machine and its performance may be reduced. So, if cooling is not perfect and temperature rise is ignored, insulation is affected. Insulation resistance must not be less than 1 mega ohm. If its measurement is ignored, it will affect the system operation. 3rd, brush sparking, bad commutation, damages commutator or slip rings and performance be affected. 4th one is brush tension, brush seating, brush clearance shall be properly inspected. If not, then performance is affected. 5th, if maintenance of cooling systems if not proper, ventilating ducts are clogged, fans bent, then winding and case temperature increases, which affects the insulation. Moreover, more loss of energy and hence efficiency decreases. 6th, if overload is persisted for a longer time, then due to increased currents, more heat is generated and insulation damages. 7th, overspeed also makes the operation more noisy and bearings may be damaged. 8th one is lubrication, if not attended to, then mechanical losses are increased, efficiency decreases and shaft bearings damage. Next topic is maintenance schedule for induction motor. So on hourly maintenance, first one is for important machine check and major voltage current, compare with rate figures given on nameplate. Second, check and measure the ambient temperature. Third one is for important machine check and measure the surface temperature of stator winding and bearing temperature. Ensure that temperature rise within permissible limit. On daily maintenance, after completing activities during hourly schedule, following activities are necessary during daily schedule. So in daily schedule, first one is check the physical condition of machine. Machine should be kept clean and dry. Third, check the accessories like starter, relays and control equipments. Checking of cooling arrangements, checking lubricating system. Air passage for ventilation should be clean for cooling system to check the motor earthing connection. To check the vibrators, noise and coupling. In case of indirect drive, check the belt tension and condition. Next, for weekly maintenance, after completing activities during daily schedule, following activities are necessary during weekly schedule. And the first is examine contacts of starting equipment and protective equipment. In case of slew bearings, motor check, air gap, alignment should be thoroughly checked. All bolts, nuts, fasteners, etc. shall be thoroughly checked. In monthly maintenance, after completing activities during weekly schedule, following activities are necessary during monthly schedule. In the first is check condition of lubricating oil, clean machine internally by industrial vacuum pump, check insulation resistance, check the bearing condition, Slipping seat must be clean. Next is half yearly maintenance. After completing activities during weekly maintenance, following activities are necessary during half yearly schedule. The first is cleaning of motors internally and externally against affected due to surrounding atmosphere condition. Check grease in ball and roller bearings. Check slip rings against unequal wearing. Check for signs of corrosion of metallic parts. Fifth one is varnishing and baking is carried out if found necessary. Next is yearly maintenance. After completing activities during half yearly maintenance, following activities are necessary during yearly schedule. The first is check bearing against worn out. Check the brushes against worn out. Check the slip rings against worn out. Check the condition of starting and protective equipment. Check the condition of foundation, check the insulation resistance, and check the earth resistance. Next is maintenance schedule for synchronous machines. And the first inspection frequency is monthly. For monthly basis, you have to inspect ball and roller bearings. Make sure that grease or oil is not leaking out of the bearing housing. Check the nose of bearings, check oil level and color of oil, and action required if any leakage in ball and roller bearings, that is oil present in these bearings, and if there is leakage is present, repair it before use. Nosy bearings, if any, may be replaced by new one at time of shutdown. Check oil level in bearings. So if color became dark, replace it immediately. Next, you have to inspect brushes. Check length of brushes. If worn out, then you have to replace them. Next is commutation. So check the commutator for roughness. Carry out wiping of commutator with a brush or lintless cloth. Next is collector. So check the collector for roughness, dust and wear. Wipe with brush or cloth. Check if brushes are bouncing up and down on a cycle basis. Check for collector ring continuity. Next, you have to inspect air filters. Check if clogged filters, replace, otherwise causes overheating. Next one is bolts. Perform visual observation for loose bolts, loose parts or loose electrical connections. Take visual observation and do the needful. Noise and vibrations. So check for unusual noise, vibration or change from previous observations. Rectify if necessary. Next, on 6 months basis, you have to inspect bearings, roller and ball, listen to all bearing, pull back bearing cap to inspect grease condition, take samples of oil taste it as suggested by manufacturer, replace if necessary. Next, you have to check commutator, check riser for crackers, do the needful if there is cracks. Next, check ends of shaft, keyway and shaft pan. Next, we have to inspect insulation. Measure 1 minute and 10 minute insulating resistance. Calculate polarization index and compare with previous record. Wipe deposits from brush holder stud insulation and commutator creepage path. Remove heavy deposits from around field coil connections, blow deposits out with clean dry air, make visual inspection for signs of overheating. Next, you have to inspect mechanical bolts, check all electrical connections for tightness, look for signs of poor connections, that is arcing, discoloration, etc. Inspect foundation for signs of cracking. And if so, then you have to take necessary action. So do the needful. Next, you have to inspect shaft. Check corners of the exposed ends of the shaft and keyway for the cracks due to torsion. And if there are cracks, then you have to take necessary action. So check and do the needful. Next, you have to inspect ventilation. Check for clogging of screens and filters, etc., and clean the same. Next is vibrations. Check the balance and alignment and do the needful. On yearly basis, you have to check bearings. So drain out housing, remove the top half of bearing, bearing housing, inspect bearing surface and the rings. See also bottom half of bearings. If slug is found at the bottom of housing, then you have to clean it. So this is the maintenance schedule for synchronous machine.